So did you finally get that PS5 you've always wanted? And now that you've got it, you want to start doing some streaming? Well, today I'm going to show you the one thing you need to be able to do that. And I'm going to give you my honest opinion whether you should buy it or not. Because I've been using it for a little while now, and I've definitely got some thoughts on it. So let's get to it. So when I decided to start doing some streaming on my PS5, I researched what was available, and the only thing you can use is the PlayStation HD webcam. And this is for specifically for the PS5. This does not work on PS4. And you can't use any other webcam on the PS5. It has to be the Sony PlayStation HD webcam. I did a lot of research and video watching, trying to decide whether it was worth buying. And I'll say that most of the reviews I saw, they said, oh, yeah, this is great. Image quality isn't the best, but it's decent. And they recommend buying it. So I went ahead and bought it. Well, I can tell you that no, it's not worth buying. And let me tell you why. At first, I had it hooked up to some monitors on my desk. 27 inch 1440 monitor. And so that put me probably 2 or 3 feet away from the camera. Well, when you're that close to the camera, no matter what kind of light you have, it just blows your face out. The image quality is not good. So I moved back a little bit. The image got a little bit better, but being on a monitor, I couldn't really see the screen like I wanted to see it. So I had a Samsung 2024 OLED, the S90D, on order. And so when that came in, I thought, okay, that's what I wanted to do my gaming on anyways. I put my PlayStation on it, and the chair I sit in sits probably 6 feet or so from the television. So I mounted the camera on top of the TV. And yeah, still no bad image quality. It is better because it doesn't blow the colors out, it doesn't wash your face out, but you're so far away from it, you can't really see anything. And you definitely can't really interact with the camera because you're too far. No matter what kind of lighting I did, I put some of my lights I use for my videos in place. I tried to change camera angle. And unfortunately, this camera has no way of mounting it on any kind of tripod. So you can't even move it from the PlayStation closer to you in a different angle to try that. It's kind of on the TV or on your monitor or nothing. I've seen people, create some custom mounts and, drill holes and put a thread, but who wants to go through all that? You just want to be able to buy the camera and connect it and stream with it. Now, the connecting it and setting it up is super easy. So, I mean, that's a plus. But the main reason you get it is for image quality. And the image quality on this device is terrible. So, I can't recommend it at all. I really wish Sony would allow you to use a third-party webcam that maybe you could get a, 4K signal from or something. The port they use on the back is a USB 3.1. So, it supports the 10 gigabit bandwidth. So I don't understand why they're restricting you to this 1080p. I don't even know, the type of sensors that's in the camera. It's obviously not a very high megapixel camera. And its ability to manage low light situations is horrendous. And to be all honest with you, that's really the only time you're going to be gaming is in low light situations because I do most of my gaming at night. And I like the lights off or down, so I get fantastic, color reproduction. And this new Samsung OLED is amazing. The colors look fantastic. So I don't want a bunch of light washing everything out. I don't know what the solution will be unless Sony wants to come up with some way of doing a third-party camera, or maybe there's a way they can publish a software update to this camera to improve its image capability, or at least give you better control over adjusting the image quality. Because the contrast and brightness and those settings they have that's in the PlayStation, they don't do anything really other than just wash you out more, or maybe make you look too dark or something. I really don't understand, you know, why they put this camera out, honestly, because they had to have known this image quality was not good. Listen, it's like $60. Don't waste your money. And unfortunately, for someone like myself, that I don't do any PC gaming. I don't have any PC games at all. Everything I do is on my PlayStation 5. And I like to sit in my nice, comfortable chair in front of my television to do that gaming. So the only thing I'm going to be able to do is get a capture card, get an HD webcam, and hook that up to a computer that can record and stream the gameplay at the same time. Then I can take that camera and I can move it pretty much anywhere I want, as long as I have USB length, and I can adjust image quality. I can use specific, you know, like one type, you know, studio light, so to speak, instead of having every light on in the room to even get a fraction of a good image quality. This camera is not worth it. Don't buy it. If you want to do some streaming and recording from your PlayStation in excellent image quality, you're going to have to use a capture card. And I'll probably be having a video coming up here real soon showing you the capture card and how it works, because I believe I'm going to order one. I have an extra computer that I can use to connect everything, and I think that's what I'm probably going to do. So you'll definitely want to come back. So hit that like, subscribe, and then hit that bell icon, because you'll definitely want to get notified when that comes. And you'll definitely want to go watch this video here on that Samsung S90D OLED TV, because it's amazing.